Well, the fight against the H1N1 flu has become a waiting game for millions who can't get the vaccine, and we promise to keep you informed. The government is behind schedule by millions of doses. Early forecasts predicted there would be 40 million doses available by late October. So far, there are just 13 million. Health officials insist there are no shortages of the vaccine, just delays, and production should catch up in December. Waiting for that vaccine is not easy when you want to protect your child, yet neither is waiting when you want a vaccination for yourself. But the two are linked, and it explains why kids will probably get the vaccine before you do. KMBC 9's Martin Augustine live to show us. Martin?
Laura, tonight here at the Clay County Health Department, 500 toddlers and preschool-aged children received the H1N1 vaccine. And even though you as a grown-up may not have received a vaccination tonight, the vaccinations that the kids got in the form of a nasal mist will end up protecting you, too.
While they may not like it, these children are doing us a favor. All between the ages of 2 and 4, they're more likely, if they catch H1N1, to give the virus to their parents and siblings or the other kids in their playgroup, who in turn could give it to their parents and siblings.
They have a tendency to help spread the disease.
That's why health officials here adopted a strategy of vaccinating children before adults, with a limited supply so far of H1N1 vaccine, using the doses first with this age group they believe will more likely slow the spread of the flu to all age groups. And Clay County has some evidence this works. Listen to what happened in Clay County during last year's seasonal flu season.
We did feel like we saw a slight decrease in the total number of reported influenza cases last year. And the one thing that we did differently last year was we made a focus of trying to immunize more children against seasonal flu.
Parents, however, are worried less about the strategy and are just glad to have it done.
See the things that this virus is doing to kids and little people, it's just awful, and we want to prevent that. So we're awful glad they did this today.
I work in healthcare, so I don't want to bring anything home to her.
I just feel like that the vaccine, any dangers from the vaccine, are very few compared to, the benefits he's going to get from not getting H1N1.
Clay County health officials did want us to pass along to you that even if your child did not receive an H1N1 vaccination today, more H1N1 vaccine is on the way. Reporting live in Liberty, Martin Augustine, KMBC 9 News.